In the last days, God says, I will pour out my spirit on all people. Your sons and daughters will prophesy. Your young men will see visions. Your old men will dream dreams.
Listen to my words. When there is a prophet among you, I, the Lord, reveal myself to them in visions. I speak to them in dreams.
For God does speak, now one way, now another, though no one perceives it. In a dream, in a vision of the night, when deep sleep falls on people as they slumber in their beds, he may speak in their ears and terrify them with warnings, to turn them from wrongdoing and keep them from pride, to preserve them from the pit, their lives from perishing by the sword.
Then Joseph said to Pharaoh,
"The dreams of Pharaoh are one and the same. God has revealed to Pharaoh what he is about to do."
One night the Lord spoke to Paul in a vision.
"Do not be afraid. Keep on speaking. Do not be silent. For I am with you, and no one is going to attack and harm you, because I have many people in this city."
"Why do you look so sad today?"
"We both had dreams," they answered, "but there is no one to interpret them."
Then Joseph said to them,
"Do not interpretations belong to God? Tell me your dreams."
And God spoke to Israel in a vision at night and said,
"Jacob, Jacob."
"Here I am,"
he replied.
"I am God, the God of your father,"
he said.
"Do not be afraid to go down to Egypt, for I will make you into a great nation there."
"In my vision at night I looked, and there before me was one like a son of man, coming with the clouds of heaven. He approached the Ancient of Days and was led into his presence.
After this, the word of the Lord came to Abram in a vision.
"Do not be afraid, Abram. I am your shield, your very great reward."
And having been warned in a dream not to go back to Herod, they returned to their country by another route.